Tech-inspired fashion having an effect on the fashion industry. Issue, a tech-infused fashion brand, first launched the Anti-Flash Scarf in 2015. Also known as the Invisibility Cloak and the Anti-Paparazzi Scarf, the fashion line initially took off among celebrities. Now the brand's designing clothes that can help generate electricity. For more, we're joined by the company's CEO, Seth Siddiqui. Seth, welcome to Post 9.
Thank you so much.
So, I've seen the coverage of the scarf. Really interesting product. And I guess the question is, how do you bring more products to bear? And we've had questions about if we're going to really have tech fashion for a long time. There was the iPod coats, where the headphones are supposed to be built in. None of it's really seemed to take off. What's been missing?
I honestly think that the fashion industry has just been oblivious to the potential behind technology and infusing that with fashion. It's really not rocket science, and it's really weird to see that no big brand, no corporate brand has ever taken a step into bringing technology into fashion, whether it's Bluetooth or Wi-Fi in clothes, or people carry around power bars to charge their phone. We should be able to charge our clothes through solar energy, et cetera, et cetera. So that's where I step in.
Now, really slim silhouettes are in right now. I mean, even men's pants gotten really tight. Yeah. How are you going to fit solar panels in that?
Nanotechnology, that's the key.
Okay.
Yeah, so similar to the anti-paparazzi scarf, it's all nanotechnology.
But what are you charging? What is it that you're charging? Why do your clothes need to be charged? Why do they need electricity?
So your phone is always charged on the go.
So what happens if I touch you right now? Am I going to get like an electric shock or something?
It's solar energy, so it's all sustainable energy.
So you're telling me that I'm going to wear a piece of clothing, put my phone in the pocket, and it's going to charge my phone?
Absolutely.
You can do that already?
I mean, it's 2017.
But can you do that with your clothes right now?
Of course, I can do that exactly right now.
Charge your phone
on the go.
On your clothes.
I mean, why has technology and fashion never met? You know what I mean? It's not rocket science, like I said. It's very, very simple. And with Issue, we have plans to take it even a step further. Within the next 2.5 years, we're going towards kinetic energy, which basically means you can go for a run, charge your clothes at the end of your marathon, and have your phone charged, so you don't have to.
Can
go
I
home.
Sell it onto the grid? Because this, you know, then we've got a business model, John. Right? We can, you know, you can make some money off of it. You know, if you're a marathoner, you can get a pretty good income going.
I wonder when it comes to being able to practically wash these clothes. I mean, is it going to be dry clean only? If you've got these components in there, you know, the wire to connect to your phone or whatever, is that going to cause wear and tear? I mean, have you worked out all of the minute issues?
Absolutely. I mean, you can take an iPhone 7 into water. So a cable in water is absolutely fine. The main thing for us is, you know, using solar energy to charge your clothes and generate electricity. For me personally, you know, the potential behind being able to, I mean, there's 1.3 billion people without electricity every single day on the other side of the planet, whether it's Africa or India. So creating a product similar to this, or if any other fashion brand wants to step into it, we can help other people.
But how much does it cost?
The price really ranges from about $50, and we can go all the way up to about $700. So the initial scarves we started selling at $350 to $400, a bit higher end into the luxury industry. And we dropped the prices down actually to around $115, $200 now.
All right, Seth Siddiqui from Issue.
Thank you very much for having me.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.